two families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Yeah. Well, welcome to Family Feud South Africa, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Yeah. Yeah. Told y'all I was coming. They didn't believe it. They did a little press conference. Everybody, Steve ain't coming to Africa. Yeah, he is. Steve Harvey didn't come to Africa. Steve Harvey came home. Yeah. Yeah. Boy, this is gonna be good. You all have no idea what you are in store for. I'm a bad man. This is what I do, man. We're gonna do some laughing. We're gonna learn a lot about each other. It's gonna be a cultural exchange. This is gonna be a wonderful experience. I'm so happy to be here, man. Let's just get it on. Now, our researchers for Family Feud have been out on the streets of Mzunzi. Pretty sure I didn't say that right, but say it again.
Mzunzi. Yes.
What you're not gonna do is have an attitude with me. Mzunzi. So they've been out on the streets of Mzunzi. Yeah. And they're asking you to answer some really simple questions, everybody. Our families are gonna try to guess the top answers, okay? Yeah. From Musgrave in Durban, it's the Mariano family. Yeah. And from the Observatory, right here in Johannesburg, it's the Kasongo family. Yeah. Everybody's here trying to win themselves some cash, and somebody could have walked out of here with a jackpot of 75,000 rand. Give me Marcelino, give me Bernice. You all are the first contestants to ever play Family Feud on the continent of Africa.
Fantastic.
The two of you will go in the Guinness World Book of Records.
Yeah.
How about it? Let's go. All right, everybody, one hand on the desk, one hand behind your back. We've got the top five answers on the board. Here we go. If Steve Harvey moved to South Africa, which province should he be living in?
Gauteng province.
Huh?
Gauteng. Johannesburg province.
Oh, Gauteng.
Yeah, Gauteng.
I'm going to Gauteng. Steve Harvey's in Gauteng. Yeah! Pass or play?
Pass or play? Play.
You gonna play?
Play. Play.
Play.
Play.
Gauteng?
Gauteng.
Gauteng.
That spells Gauteng.
Gauteng.
Oh, no.
This is gonna be quite a cultural experience for me. I'm the fish out of water on this show. All right, here we go. Marcelino, I want you to introduce your family. Who'd you bring with you?
This is my son, Durao. That's my niece, Chelsea. That's my daughter-in-law, Shaylee, one and only. And that's my youngest son, Jose, or Jose.
Yeah. All right. Durao?
Durao.
Durao. Yes. How you doing, man? What do you do for a living?
I'm actually studying education now.
Yeah, how old are you?
I'm actually 28 years old.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good.
I don't look it right.
No, you look really young. You look young, though. That's good. You be a teacher. We need more teachers. We need more men teachers.
That's it. That's
you need
that's
more
exactly
men
it.
In the school system. Give these boys some guidance. All right, let's go, man. If Steve Harvey moved to South Africa, which province should he live in?
The Western Cape.
Good answer.
Yes,
Western Cape.
Good answer.
Chelsea, how are you?
I'm well, thanks, and you, Mr.
Good,
Harvey?
Good. What do you do for a living?
Well, I'm a med student.
Oh, wow, you're really smart.
That's debatable.
No, you can't be a med student and, like, be me. I can't go to med school. I can't read that good. I fill out your prescription, you're gonna die. And what else do you do?
Sir? I play the saxophone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really musician. Good?
I'd like to think so.
Who's your favorite saxophone player?
Ooh, this is gonna be unconventional, but I love Charlie Parker.
Really?
I mean, some bebop. It's hard listening, but.
Charlie Parker?
Charlie Parker. Wow. I can't play any of his things to save my life.
I didn't think so. Say, this little girl can play Charlie Parker? Congratulations, let's play.
Thank
if
you.
Steve Harvey moved to South Africa, which province should he live in?
KwaZulu-Natal.
KwaZulu-Natal.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. That sounds good to me.
Yeah.
Steve Harvey gonna build things. KwaZulu-Natal, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it just makes me want to do that.
Yeah.
Let's go. Whatever she's Guzula could come to the town.
Yes!
Abbreviated you, Steve Harvey.
What? Oh, that's abbreviation.
Yeah.
I said, wait a minute. I'm gonna be in a lot of trouble trying to. All right, that'll work right here. Hi, how are you? What happened to your name tag?
Ooh, here we go. So sorry.
Hey, Shaylee, how you doing?
Good, thanks. How are you?
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm an advanced life support paramedic.
Yes, that's
but
my
I'm
baby.
Obsessed with my cats.
You upset with your cat? What did you
no,
do?
No, I'm obsessed. Like crazy about
oh,
my cat.
Oh, upset?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you said you was upset with your cat. Put his ass out. Get your cat. So you're obsessed with your cat.
Yes, I love her.
What does that mean?
She's like my daughter. I feel she understands. She's got human tendencies.
Really?
Yes.
Cats don't listen.
Yes.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes, they don't listen.
Is your cat trained? Does it do anything?
She catches the aunties. So I've trained her that flies, mosquitoes, or aunties. And so when they're in the house, I say, catch the auntie, and she goes for them. Promise.
Oh, really?
Yep.
First time I've ever heard anybody get their cat to do anything. Catch the aunties. The mosquitoes, the damn mosquitoes. All right, well, let's go, Shaylee. Steve Harvey moved to South Africa. Which province should he live in?
I'm gonna say the Northern Cape.
The Northern Cape? No, I don't wanna stay there. I don't even. Oh. And ain't nobody clapped. Nobody clapped. The Northern Cape. See, let me tell you something. If they don't clap for your answer, see, they clap for the, like when he said,
Gauteng.
Gauteng, it worked. Hey, Jose?
Yes, sir, you can go with Jose.
Okay, what is it then?
In South Africa, I was the only Jose, yeah? And so I enjoyed the name. But when I went overseas, everywhere I looked, there's Jose. I'm like, Jose, I'm like, hey, hi. So this is called me Jose. Welcome to South Africa, Steve.
S- So let me see if I can work through this. No one in South Africa's name is Jose.
That I know of.
That you know of.
Yes,
but
sir.
You went to the States, you and saw Jose's everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yeah, that's true.
Hardworking man.
Hardworking? Yeah. Very hardworking. Yeah. We're not allowed to do those jokes in the United States anymore. Yeah, we get put off the air, so I'm gonna just let you say what you said. And Steve Harvey gonna leave that alone. What do you do for a living?
Well, I was in hospitality most of my life, and I recently became a firefighter.
Oh, okay, that's pretty good, yeah. That's pretty good, man. All right, let's go, Jose. If Steve Harvey moved to South... You only got one strike. If Steve Harvey moved to South Africa, which province should he live in?
I'm going to go with the Northwest province.
Good answer!
Okay. Make it easy for you, Steve.
Well, okay, the Northwest! All right, we got two strikes. We got to be careful now. The Kasongo family can steal. Marcelino? Two strikes, be careful. Steve Harvey moved to South Africa. Which province should he live in?
Eastern Cape.
Yes. Yes.
They're clapping again.
Yeah.
This is why you the captain.
Yes.
I don't know where that is, but it sounds good. Eastern Cape. Only one answer left. You could clear the board.
Woo.
You're sweating pretty hard. You're trying to be a teacher. This is your moment to shine. All you got to do is get one answer right.
Yes, come on.
If not, what kind of teacher are you? Steve Harvey moved to South Africa. Which province should he live in?
Mpumalanga.
Yes!
I like that. Yeah. Hey, Steve, where you stay? I stay in the Big Pony. They probably call it the Big Pony, Pony Longo, man. I like that. I stay in the Pony Longo. Pony Longo is long. Pony Longo! Ladies, here we go. There's one answer left. Your chance to steal. If Steve Harvey moved to South Africa, which province should he live in?
Limpopo.
Yeah! Limpopo. Yeah! Limpopo.
Yeah!
Y'all like that?
Yeah!
Limpopo.
It's there.
We got a game, folks. Mariano family not on the board. The Sango family got 84.
Yay!
Don't go away. We'll be right back. We're playing Family Feud in South Africa, baby. Yeah. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Well, the Mariano family's not on the board. The Kasongo family got 84.
Yeah!
Let's give it all. Give me Duran, give me Merlin.
Yeah!
It's really nice. All right, all hands in position. All right, we surveyed 100 people. We've got the top six answers on the board. Here we go. Name something you can do legally when you turn 18.
Get a driver's license.
Get a driver's license.
Yeah. Drink alcohol.
Drink alcohol.
Play, right? Play.
We're gonna play. All right, Chelsea, here we go. Name something you could do legally when you turn 18.
Get into clubs.
Wow, great.
Get into the club.
What you know about that, right? Come on.
Yes! Didn't you just tell me you were in med school?
I am, yeah. Mr. Harvey.
When do you have time? to we hit don't. The club. You don't?
No, we don't, sir.
You don't have time for that. OK. Shaylee, how are you?
Good.
All right, here we go. The cat is watching, so let's get this right. Name something you can do legally when you turn 18.
I'm going to say get married.
Yes. Yes, you're on to it.
Get married. All right, only one strike. That's all. No problem. My man, Jose. Here we go, baby. This is going to be good. Young dude like
okay,
you.
I like it.
We're about to find out. How old are you, Jose?
I'm 27.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You've been 18 for a little while now. Let's see what it meant to you. Name something you could do legally when you turn 18.
I'm going to go with smoking.
You can smoke. Smoking. Marcelino, we're rolling right along, buddy. Name something you can do legally when you turn 18.
This is easy. Get your identity document.
Good answer, man.
So, like, if I live here, could I get one?
No, you need to. If you, you need to be a certain amount of years in South Africa to qualify.
Oh, I got to be here a certain amount of years. I don't know, man. I'll probably stay here about 10 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
10 years.
I just got to find the right place to live.
Come to KZN, KwaZulu-Natal.
South Africa.
The beach.
Come to KwaZulu-Natal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lovely place.
The beach.
Ocean. Yeah.
Okay, that sounds good. I like water. Y'all got sharks in y'all water, though. Yeah, ain't no swimming out there. You just... All right, your documents.
Yes, it's got to be there.
Oh, no.
We got two strikes. You got to be careful. The Kasongo family can steal. My man, name something you could do legally when you turn 18.
Get credit.
Get credit.
Yes, good answer.
Good answer.
Credit.
You can get credit. Ladies, here we go. Here's your chance. Name something you can do legally when you turn 18.
You can gamble.
Yeah!
We can gamble. All right, let's look at the last answer. Number two. Well, that was round two, everybody. The Mariano family not on the board. The Kasongo family got 158. Don't go away. After the break, our families will be playing for double the points. We're playing Feud. We got a good game, man. You're playing well. Don't worry about it. All right, everybody, welcome back to Family Feud. We got a good one. The Mariano family not on the board. The Kasongo family got 158. Let's get it on. Give me Chelsea. Give me Balungu. Now, did I say your name right?
Yeah.
Balungu?
Balungu.
Oh, I see you, girl.
Yeah.
All right, now. All right, everybody ready? Surveyed the top 100 people. We got the top five answers on the board. Here we go. If Steve, that's me, if Steve was your blesser, what should he buy you as a gift?
A house.
That's a big blessing right there. Gonna have to find out what this means. House!
Diamonds, Steve. Jewelry.
Diamonds, jewelry.
Diamonds, yeah.
Diamonds, jewelry. Pass
play.
Or play?
Play.
Play. Okay, help me understand something, because this is not what we call it. If Steve was your blesser, what blesser, like, what does that mean? Like,
it's like a sugar daddy.
It's a what?
Sugar daddy.
A sugar daddy?
Yeah.
Oh, hell no.
You've got the money. You've got the
Wait
money.
A minute.
You've got the money.
If Steve was your blesser,
yeah.
A blesser is a sugar daddy?
Yeah.
You loaded.
I be damned. And then look at her little greedy self, a house. So Bernice, you're the team captain. Introduce everybody.
This is Marlene, she's my sister. This is Bulungu Priscilla, she's my cousin. That's Jemima, she's my sister. And that's Katie at the end, she's my cousin.
Yeah. All right.
Wow. Jemima.
Jemima?
Yes.
What do you do?
I'm a student.
You're in college?
Yes.
High school?
University.
Oh, university.
Yes.
Okay. It's a big difference between a college and a university. Okay, what's the difference between a college and a university?
Well, basically, university, they need the good grades, and then college is like...
Oh, that's everybody. Where I have to go.
Yeah.
Oh, I go to college. University, you need good grades. College, just come on and try. Yeah. There we go. If Steve was your blesser, that is me. Your sugar daddy.
Yes, Uncle Steve.
What should he buy you as a gift?
Well, a holiday trip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes,
yes,
girl.
A holiday trip.
We're going to Dubai.
We're going to Dubai.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Have you been to Dubai?
No, that's why you're my blesser. You're going to take me to Dubai. Yeah. That's how it works. You do things you've never done before and things you can't afford, basically.
I do things I've never done before.
When you have a blesser, you do things that you've never done before and you ask for things you don't have. Yeah. So, yeah.
So, let me ask you this here.
Yeah.
My wife, Marjorie, am I her blesser?
No.
Oh, yes, I am.
You're blessing each other.
Because we just left Dubai.
Oh, I know that. I've been stalking you, Steve. We know that.
Trip, holiday. Katsia.
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 Yes.
What do you do?
I'm an architecture student.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh. Watch this, watch this. At the university.
Yes, at the university.
Yeah. Yeah. You can't be an architecture student at the college. No, can't have you stupid building a building. No, you don't build a building, you just go get the rocks. Hold the shovel. Okay, so how long have you been at the university?
I'm going into my second year.
Okay, good. All right, you ready?
Yes.
If Steve was your blesser, what would he buy you as a gift?
I'd appreciate a car.
Yeah. Car!
Come on. It's this.
Yeah. All right, we only got one strike. Bernice, if Steve was your blesser, what should he buy you as a gift?
He could buy me a ring.
I think that's jewelry. That's under jewelry. A ring is under jewelry.
He could buy me expensive clothes. Yeah.
Expensive clothes. Two strikes. We gotta be careful, Marlene. The Mariano family can steal. Be careful. This is a big one. Steve was your blesser. What should he buy you as a gift?
He could actually give me a big check.
Yes! 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 Yes!
let me ask you a question. How much? Like, if I wrote you a check, what's a big check to you?
Wow. Steve, how much do you have in your bank account?
It depends on which bank account you're talking about.
I'm talking about your savings, Steve.
Girl, you must not know who you're talking to.
Sorry.
You just tell me how much your little heart can think of. I probably got it. Bless her! How much would you want?
Because I'm a generous person, Steve, so I'm just going to ask for $50
million. $50
million? Because I'm generous, not in dollars.
$50 million. You're not getting no damn $50 million out there. I don't give a damn. You ain't blessing me that much. $50 million? You know who you got to be? Your name would have to be Marjorie.
No!
Yeah. Ain't nobody.
I'm close.
50
Steve.
Million.
I'm very close.
A big check. Well, listen to me. They got 158. There's 158 up there. You could tie this game right up. Your chance to steal. If Steve was your blesser, what should he buy you as a gift?
Expensive shoes.
There we go. Yes.
Expensive shoes. What kind of shoes, Shaylee?
Some red bottoms.
Red bottoms. Shoes.
Shoes.
Yes. Yes.
Number four.
Phone.
Phone. All right, that was round three, everybody. We got a game now. Mariano family, 158. Kasongo family got 158. Uh-oh. We're playing Feud now in South Africa, baby. Don't go away. After the break, we're going to be playing for double the points. Oh, we got a good one. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. And boy, we got a good one today. Mariano family, 158. Kasongo family, 158. Let's get it on. Give me Shaylee. Give me Djimijimajima. Okay, they spelled it wrong in the teleprompter.
Well, it's a French name, so
it's
you
a
say
French
Jemima.
Name. Jemima. All right, let's go. In this round, lady, point values are double. 100 people surveyed. We have the top five answers on the board. Name something on your bucket list.
A holiday.
A holiday. Yeah. Well, so far, all your answers been holiday. Finally, it's up there. Steve's gonna ask me something. I'm going to say holiday. I don't care what the question is. Pass or play?
Play.
Let's play. I can see a name something on your bucket list.
I'm very adventurous, so I'll say skydiving. Yeah.
Black people don't like skydiving. Skydiving! They must have surveyed some white Africans. That's funny. I don't care if you tighten up, that's funny. Hey, Bernice.
Yes.
Name something on your bucket list.
I'd climb the highest mountain in Africa.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
What is the highest mountain in Africa?
Mine, Kilimanjaro, I think.
Kilimanjaro?
Yeah!
Is that right?
Yeah!
Where is that? What
Isn't
country?
It's in Kenya.
It's in Kenya, Kilimanjaro.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Okay, well, let's climb it. Climb the highest mountain.
Yeah. has to be there. Come on.
Marlene, name something on your bucket list.
A road trip.
Yeah! Yes! Yes!
A road trip, Steve!
A road trip.
Oh, a road trip.
Yes!
I thought you said a roach clip.
What?
What the hell? Is a roach clip over here the same thing as it is in the States?
We don't know what that is.
A roach clip. That's a cultural thing. A roach clip is a little... Let's do this off the air. A road trip!
It's there. You know it. Right
there. Oh. Come on! Yes!
Yes! Woo! Woo!
All right, only one strike.
Uh-huh.
Only one strike. Ma'am, name something on your bucket list.
Try on a new hairstyle.
Yeah.
Woo! Yes!
Yes!
A new hairstyle.
A new hairstyle. That's on your bucket list? You could do that tonight.
It's on this, Steve.
We could go to commercial break and you could just brush it over on one side. Bam. Oh, thank you. Put that on your bucket list. It's a new hairstyle, folks with little dreams. All right, we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful. The other family can steal. Name something on your bucket list.
Become a millionaire.
Become a millionaire, yeah. Yeah. Let's get rich. That was a good answer. Good answer. All right, we got a tie score. This is gonna break it. Name something on your bucket list.
This is easy, Steve.
Okay.
Bungee jumping.
Yes.
Yes. Yes! That's a good answer. Everybody's going bungee jumping.
Bungee jumping.
Bungee jumping?
Yes.
Will Smith did it.
Number five. Well, it's the last round, everybody, and there's everything to play for. Right now, the Moriano family has 292, and the Casango family got 158. Now, remember, whoever, whatever family has the most points at the end of this round goes on to play Fast Money and has a chance of walking out of here with the jackpot of 75,000 rand. So let's get it on, everybody. Give me Jose. Give me Casilla. All right, here we go. We've got the top five answers on the board. And in this round, the points have been tripled. Good luck. Here we go. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
Food.
Food.
Yeah. I'm gonna go with a hug.
A hug. Pass the play. We're gonna play. All right, Bernice, here we go. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
Tea.
Yeah!
Tea? Really?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Tea!
Woo! Yes! Yes, girl! Yes!
Yes!
Never went over my grandmother's house and she offered me tea.
This is South Africa, Steve.
Yeah, I just need something to eat. I don't give a damn about no tea. All right, let's go. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
Cookies or biscuits?
Cookies or biscuits? I got to move to Africa. You go over to your grandmama's house, all your ass doing is eating. You get some hot food, you get some cookies, you get some tea. Everything she can make is hot. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
A piece of jewelry.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah. What?
Jewelry.
A piece of jewelry?
Yeah.
Who is y'all's grandmother? Jewelry. All right, only one strike. All right, let's keep it going. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
Chores. She'd send you right in the kitchen for you to start working.
Yeah. House chores.
Get in there, chores. Do something. Wonderful. Eat your food. You're going to go to work.
Yeah.
Come on, hurry up. Eat the biscuit. Eat the biscuit. Got to wash these dishes. Chores. All right, listen to me. You got to be careful now. You got two strikes. Mariano family can steal. This is important. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
A gift.
Yeah. A gift.
Sweet.
All right, y'all don't look too sure about this. Name something a grandmother would offer you when you visit her.
Sweets.
What?
Sweets.
Candy.
Sweets.
Candy.
South Africa will say sweets, you all say candy.
Sweets. Number five.
Money.
Well, Kasongo family, ladies, you played really, really well. You really did. You ought to smile. You all did really, really good. Well, but you did pretty good, though. So you're gonna be taking away 7,900 rand and KFC for a whole year worth 10,000 rand. Our friends over at KFC is gonna take care of this family, so enjoy your meal. Ladies, you played absolutely fantastic.
Thank you,
thanks to the folks at KFC. We're gonna have a good one. Hey, listen, everybody. Mariano family, who's playing Fast Money? We need two players. I got Marcelino, and I got Shay Lee. We'll be right back. We're gonna play Fast Money for the jackpot, 75,000. We'll be right back, 75,000 rand. All right, everybody, welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Mariano family won the game. And now it's time to play. All right, this is how it's gonna work, Shaylee. Marcelino is off stage. He can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you five questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just pass. If you and Mariano together come up with 200 points, look right there, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
75,000 rand!
Yeah. All right. You ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Name a popular sport in South Africa.
Soccer.
Name something your dog shouldn't chew.
The furniture.
Something you need to make a burger.
Patties.
Something that grows on your face.
Pimples.
Something people do with their dogs.
Take them for a walk.
Very good. Very good. Charming, gal. Okay, let's go. Let's see how we do. All right, here we go. Let's see how we did. Name a popular sport in South Africa. You said? soccer. Survey said. Something your dog shouldn't chew. You said furniture. Survey said. That's okay. Something you need to make a burger. You said. That's the patty. Survey said.
Yes. Yeah.
Something that grows on your face. You said. Pimples. Survey said.
Woo!
All right. Name something people do with their dogs, you said. Take them for a walk, survey said. Boom, good job for 32. There we go. All right, come on, let's bring up Marcelino. Marcelino, how you doing, man?
I'm good, Mr.
You feel pretty good?
Yeah, I do.
Now, Shaylee is your daughter?
Daughter-in-law.
Oh, she's married to Jose.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, okay. Jose did pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shaking up to his daddy.
Oh, okay.
Now we talking.
Yeah, man, that's good. Well, let me tell you what, she did pretty good. Shaylee got 132 points.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah. You need 68 points to win. All right, I'm gonna ask you the exact same five questions, okay? You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. All right? And then I'll say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we're gonna give you 25 seconds.
No problem.
Okay? All right, here we go. You ready?
Yep.
25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. Name a popular sport in South Africa.
Rugby.
Name something your dog shouldn't chew.
Chicken bones.
Something you need to make a burger.
Patties.
Try again.
Buns.
Something that grows on your face.
Beard. Yeah.
Something people do with their dogs.
Take them for a walk.
Try again.
Swim in the ocean.
All right, let's go. Let's see how we did. All right, buddy. Here we go. We need 68 points. 68 points for 75,000 rand.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Name a popular sport in South Africa, you said. Rugby. Survey said.
Yes.
Rugby was the number one answer. You know why it's number one? Because the Springboks won the title, baby. Something your dog shouldn't chew, you said. Bones. Survey said.
Six.
Shoes. Shoes was the number one answer. We are 19 points away from 75,000 rand. Something you need to make a burger. You said the buns. Survey said. Boom. Yeah. Buns was the number one answer. Grow up something on your face, a beard was the number one answer. And take your dog for a walk was the number one answer. Well, congratulations to the Mariano family. That's 75,000 rand, baby. I'm Steve Harvey, everybody. We'll see you next time, folks.
The best.